If you find out some what Jesus said during the Passion Week or Holy Week in YouTube, you can find out some movie. So then you can see. So last week, last Sunday was called Palm Sunday. Let me briefly explain to you. Then yourself, if you are watching the movie, then you try to find out who are they, those who passed the by. But it's a failure. But when I explain something, then you should find out who they were. Okay? So, last Sunday, why we call it the Palm Sunday? Why? Because when Jesus entered Jerusalem, the people welcomed him with the palm branches. That is why we call Palm Sunday. So, can you find them? Who they were? Those who testify? Can you find them? And the next, the Monday. Monday, Jesus rode into Jerusalem on a donkey while the crowd put down their cloaks and palm leaves for him. So Monday, Jesus drove the money changers out of the temple for making it a den of thieves instead of a house of prayer. Can you remember? That was happening on Monday. Jesus was angry, turned down the table, and drove away every people. And also he cursed the bread thick tree for having leaves, but no fruits. And Tuesday, and Jesus taught from down to dust, especially parables. He pronounced oaths on the Pharisees. That was happened on Tuesday. And next, it's Wednesday. This is known as Spy Wednesday because Judas agreed to betray Jesus for such a piece of silver, the going rate for a slave at that time. Also this day, a woman anointed Jesus with expensive perfume. This was symbolic of his rebellion.
So what happened Wednesday?
So during you watching the screen, you have to find out them. Okay? You should find out them, those who are past by. Hello? Hello, please. Don't get down your hand. Watching this. Then try to find out. That was happened on Wednesday. It's like today. Physically, today is the 17th of April, 2019. But we have to go back to 2000 years ago. So we have to be there with the Jesus Christ. Are you together?
Yes.
And then Thursday. This day is known Monday Day, Monday Thursday. Because Jesus had the Last Supper with his disciples and commanded that this be done until his return. That is why we celebrate the Lord's Supper or Holy Communion in our churches. That was happened on Thursday. And finally, the Friday. This day is known as Good Friday. After tomorrow, we come Good Friday. But I'm wondering why we call the Good Friday. Jesus died on the cross. Because of holy day? No. No class? That's why it's on Friday? It's supposed to be Saturday, I think. I don't know why they call it Friday. But anyway, they call it Good Friday. You open it. It's a Good Friday. I think it doesn't make sense. Jesus was crucified for the sins of the world. For the sins of you, your sin. Don't you want to cry for me? Are you going to cry for Jesus Christ on Friday? But we have to prepare this week for that day. So many people, they intended to. What Jesus said not for us. They washing the feet of each other. They make have a Holy Communion. That is why. Even though we are here, as I told you, we have to go back at that time. So, at the Saturday, on Saturday, Jesus descended in hell and set the captives free. Death was put to death while soldiers were guarding his tomb. So nothing happened. Jesus was in the tomb. And finally, Sunday, most Christians now call this Resurrection Day. Resurrection Day. While it is commonly known as Easter Sunday, God raised Jesus from the dead early in the morning. That is why we can say He is risen. So we have to meditate what Jesus did each day. If you need this one, I can give you. If you never know before what Jesus has done each day, but we have to know that. Then we have to meditate every day, and then also we have to join with Him. Especially this week. You know, if there is no death, no cross, there is no resurrection. Most people want to have a glory. And they joy for the resurrection, but they don't want to die on the cross with Jesus Christ. How about you? Most of people join the resurrection, but they don't want to join death, the cross. As I told you, I just wonder when I read today's verses. Those who passed by, who are they? Well, who are they? Who are they nowadays? They heard him, Jesus, they laughed him, they insulted him. But when Jesus entered Jerusalem, the people welcomed Jesus. They waved the palm tree, they welcome, welcome, come. They called people. They joined, they were joyful because they welcomed the king. Then what was wrong with them? Why did they change their mind? As you see, at the first time they welcomed him, but when Jesus died on the cross, they just stood and watching him. And then they were those who passed by. Who they were? Who are they? Who are they nowadays? So I want to find them. I want to identify them. The first one, the Matthew chapter 7 says, when Jesus had finished saying these things, the crowd were amazed at his teaching. The people, those who passed by, were, because he taught as one who had authority and not as the teachers of the law. When he came down from the mountainside, large crowd followed him. Whenever he taught something and they leave there, the large crowd followed him. Especially Matthew chapter 5 to 7 is called the Sermon on the Mountain. Sermon on the Mountain. This Sermon on the Mountain is perfect human beings' ethics. I cannot explain all things, but that is very, very great teaching. Have you read? Yeah, we have to read it. Even non-Christian admire this. It's wonderful teaching. Because of his teaching, many people follow him. They want to hear. How about you? Are you? If there is some famous teacher, do you want to enjoy his lecture? Do you want it? Well, not no. If I'm a great teacher, then when I teach something, then would you join with me or not? That is natural. Because of his teaching, the wonderful teaching, the people follow to Jesus Christ. The another group was Luke chapter 5. Yet the news about him spread all the more, so that crowds of people came to hear him and to be healed of their sicknesses. Are you sick now, some of you? Are you sick? And then some of you? In pain? Then what do you want to be? You want to be healed because of our sickness. Also, there are many sickness people, and then they want to follow him because they want to be healed. Because of their sicknesses, they want to follow him. Many crowds. And the other group was John chapter 6. And a great crowd of people followed him because they saw the miraculous sign he had performed on the sea. And the next group was the people who want to see the miracle. Wow, miracle. It's some kind of magic. If I make a money through this paper, do you want to see money? 50,000 silver. Can I make it? I can't. But if someone do like this, do you want to see?
Yes.
Of course. But even Jesus Christ healed the sickest people. And then some perform the miracles. So many people want to follow him because of sin in them. Wow. And the other group in John chapter 6 as well. Jesus, knowing that they intended to come and make him king by force. What does that mean? It's a political purpose. The many people followed him, and then they intended to come and make him real king. So, if I follow someone and then he will be president, then what kind of benefit to me? I'm also get some important position and power, control the people. They won't be like that. In the last group, which I found in the Bible, John chapter 6 says that you are looking for me not because you saw the miraculous sign, but because you ate the loaves and had your fill. Hungry people. Are you hungry? Reaching out to time. But even though you don't need to go to the cafeteria, I make the something for you. We need 5 loaves and 2 fishes, and I give you all. Then you can eat and feel full. Then will you leave me? But now this is okay, but please imagine, 2,000 years ago, there is no facility like today. No school, no machine. How can they eat? But the kind of weak circumstances, Jesus gave them the food. The people won't believe in Jesus Christ. It's natural. So I introduce you the 5 groups. Those who follow Jesus Christ. Also, those who passed by. Then I want to ask it to you, where are you? Where do you belong? Where are you belonging? Are you together? Why do you want to follow Jesus Christ? Why? Why do you study here in RTC? What is the benefit? What is the profit to you to follow Jesus Christ? What do you want to be? For your purpose, your sickness, your hungry stomach, to get some power through Jesus Christ, or famous person, you want to be famous person? Then, we can be one of them, those who pass by. Yeah, we can say, I want to follow Jesus Christ without anything. Because Jesus is my Savior. He's the only one, the way to go heaven. We can say like that. But when Jesus died on the cross, the people gave up to follow Jesus Christ. Because their benefit disappeared. And even they threatened. They were threatened. Why? Because Jesus died on the cross. He was a criminal. So if I relate something with Jesus Christ, also I will be died. That's why they obeyed. They gave up to Jesus Christ. They just stood and watching him. You might think, I am not one of them. I never one of them. But think about this deeply.
We can be one of them nowadays.
We are the one who crucified Jesus Christ. We intend to follow him because of some benefit. Because I can gain something from him.
But when Jesus died on the cross, we just stood aside and stood and watched him.
So this is time to meditate ourselves. The Passion Week. The Holy Week. Are you waiting on coming Sunday? Resurrection Day? Easter Day? Are you waiting? Are you eagerly waiting?
Without suffering, without sacrificing, there is no glory. There is no resurrection. So please join the Jesus' suffering. Why Jesus should do like that? Each day. Meditate them, death, and then join Jesus' suffering, then you can also join the glory of resurrection. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So please examine yourself where you are. Where you are belonging. Are you one of them? Or not?
Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for all and with your love and grace to us. We thank you for giving us a wonderful day and your word. And this time we praise you, we honor you. Oh Father, empower us to follow in your footsteps in our lives. Remind us that why we follow Jesus. Let us find your will first, not our will, Father. You already know what we need, and you will give us as well. Father, we need everything, but these things are not our first priority. Because you gave us your only Son, most precious Son, Jesus Christ. Let us give you ours as well. Let us follow your will. Let us check our mind. Let us test our heart ourselves. So that whenever we face temptation, we can overcome the evil. Remove any evils that remain in our life, that we may see you and our place in the world clearly. Father, especially this week, let us join your suffering. Meditate the reason why you died on the cross. Father, thank you for taking sin's curse and shame so that we could experience your life and glory. Help us to find true redemption, which is found only in you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Day of resurrection in our Christian lives on the day of Easter Day.
So this is the essence of our message, I believe. So please remind yourselves and examine ourselves before the presence of God. So thank you so much for your participation for Wednesday chapel service. So I want to encourage you to be humble, especially in this week. If God touched your heart, just fasting and prayer will be great, right? To remind ourselves the suffering and death of our Lord Jesus Christ to all. I want you to welcome any other additional announcement from you. So, oh yeah.
Today we are having a learning fellowship session. Come on, come on.
Okay. Yes.
I have announced to someone who closed the phone, taking this thing. If you have come across, please bring it. And if you remain in it, will be passing.
Get up on our feet. Stand where you are. Okay. Stand where you are. So stretch your arms and hold your knees in. Let's keep our bodies. So you don't have to make your circles, but stretch your arms and hold your knees in.